it's Fran, bona fide space cadet with a very, very special project I'm announcing, the boldest yet. Everyone knows that I am a total space nut. In fact, the first video that actually launched this channel was my exploration of my vintage IBM Saturn V LVDC board, which led me to a long project that actually got me to go to the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum to do a teardown of a genuine Apollo disky, which I shared with my viewers. And then a few years after that, I got the opportunity to go to the Smithsonian again to watch Adam Savage finish the build of the Apollo 11 hatch replica that I made a latch for. And that completed hatch is now part of the permanent collection of the Smithsonian at the Air and Space Museum. And I've done videos about my Apollo collection of stuff, and that's just too many videos to mention. But top of my lifetime bucket list of things that I've always wanted to do is to fly in space. But barring some ridiculously unforeseen circumstance, I'm never getting out of the atmosphere of this planet. But after surviving 2020, I really decided that it was bucket list time. So I went and spent a small fortune of my own savings to get myself a ride on G-Force One. G-Force One is the specially modified Boeing 727 that reproduces zero gravity by flying parabolas. And among the people who've already had this adventure are Dr. Stephen Hawking, and I will be trying my hardest to try and beat that ear-to-ear grin that he has on his face. George Takei, oh my! And Sir Richard Branson and his Virgin Galactic crew, they used the G-Force One to train before they did their flight. Historically, just a few days ago. But I secured my seat, finally. This is costing me a small fortune because in addition to the fees of actually flying on G-Force One, I've also hired on a professional video crew to be able to share it with you. it's already paid for. I've already gone and done it. It is happening. It is happening. But to give an option to mitigate some of the pain of this adventure that I'm taking you with me on, I did start a GoFundMe for anybody who'd want to throw in to take the edge off, so to speak. Put a link in the description. But I'm going to run this GoFundMe up to the time that I do the flight. Like I said, I've already paid for it. It's a done deal. It's happening. Anybody wants to pitch in some pennies in the pot, it'll take the edge off the painful part of this. But I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I haven't been sleeping since I made this deal. In my mind, I'm already there. Every day I'm thinking about what I'm going to do and what it's going to be like and everything. I am so excited. So the way that they do this is that G-Force One flies to a specially allocated piece of airspace about 100 miles long that the FAA has quarantined off just for this flight. So it's like a no-fly zone just for G-Force One. And the plane does a series of parabolas ascending to an altitude of about 30,000 feet. And during the ascent, you pull about 1.8 to 2 Gs. And then as it crests over to a 30-degree nose-down descent, you experience zero gravity for about 20 to 30 seconds. The entire thing is going to be about 2 hours long. They're going to fly some 15 parabolas, and I will get about 5 minutes in zero-G, more than they got in the Virgin Galactic flight a few days ago, because they they got a measly 4 minutes. Not even 4 minutes. I'm going to have 5 minutes. And as a bonus, and this is another thing I'm really looking forward to, maybe even more than the zero gravity is, they're going to do a couple of special angled descents to simulate lunar gravity, 1/6 lunar gravity, so I'm planning to bunny hop, and also Martian gravity. And I intend to show why the Martian got it so wrong. The way that Matt Damon was moving around, it was not Martian at all. I'm going to show you what moving around on Mars would really look like. I'm going to do it for real on FranLab, because FranLab is going suborbital. Pew, baby. So this is coming up. It's, you know, we're like 8, 9, 10 weeks this is going to happen. So there's going to be a series of videos for it. Like I said, professional trained flight crew to do the videos. It is going to be the slickest, most expensive production I've ever done. So, yes. And so to take you out of this momentous announcement, I'm going to leave you with a real gem, a special treat from my collection. The first song that I ever wrote, performed by my band, a group of 5 gnarly teenagers, recorded in a basement in suburban Philadelphia in 1986. Yours truly, on guitar, preserved for posterity, on glorious chromium oxide, 0G. Enjoy.